Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I love you more than anything.
Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. All right.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
All right.
My Lord, my Lord.
Oh.
All right now.
Who opens doors that I cannot see? Jesus will. Jesus will.
All right.
Oh, and who will guide all my decisions for me? Jesus will.
Jesus will.
Come on, sing.
Hallelujah.
Our choir sing.
Hallelujah.
It's now 11:25.
Hallelujah.
Taking up the clocks have been set.
Hallelujah.
The clocks have been set. I want to receive an offering, our last offering for the year 2016. I want you to get out an offering.
Thank you, Jesus.
To the Lord for 2016.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
An offering you'd like somebody to give to you.
Hallelujah.
Even more that you want to give to God.
Hallelujah.
Like he done something for you.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let us all stand.
Glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Heavenly Father, in thy precious name,
Hallelujah.
We are grateful unto thee.
Thank you, Jesus.
For this year 2016.
Hallelujah.
And as we come with the offering at this time,
thank you,
we ask thy blessings upon it.
Thank you, Jesus.
We ask, O God, that you return it to the giver a hundredfold, even over and over again. In Jesus' name, amen. This time we want you to come quickly with your offering for the last of 2016. Your last offering. Quickly, come on.
Hallelujah.
Come on from the back.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
If you give unto the Lord, he will give you more to give. Some more to give. Some more to give. If you give unto the Lord, he will give you more to give. He will give you more to give. If you give unto the Lord, he will give you more to give. Some more to give.
Some more to give.
Some more to give.
Some more to give.
If you give unto the Lord, he will give you more to give. He will give you more to give.
Amen. Hallelujah. We trust you've given as the Lord has blessed you to give, and that you'll be prepared at the first part. At this time, I want the ministers to come and give that which God has given them, remembering those that are coming behind them. We're going to call on Sister Ware, then Sister Holloway, and then Sister Hook to come in that order.
Amen.
Come and bring forth the word that the Lord has given to you. Amen. Let's receive them with a hearty amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Bless the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah. We're going to have to turn quickly with us to 1 Timothy 6 and 12. Along with that, 2 Timothy 4.
Remember those that are behind you now.
5 and 8. 6 and 12. It says, fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, whereunto thou art also called, and hast professed a good profession before many witnesses. 2 Timothy 4. Through 8. But watch thou in all things, endure affliction, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry. For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord the righteous judge shall give me at that day. And not to me only, but unto all them also their love is appearing. Lord, we ask that thou have your way and bless thy word, bless thy servant, to minister to thy people in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We're talking about fighting the good fight
Amen.
Of faith. Everybody don't know how to fight today. Some are still fighting with their hands and their fingernails and they're scratching and they're pulling hair. That's the natural way. That's a child's way. And some think they have matured a little bit. They fight with their weapons. They've got their switchblade knives and they've got their guns, their rifles. Some have their feet. They can run. They can kick. Some use their voices. They holler and scream. It just shows you that nothing can stop the enemy because he has the same weapons. And if he really wants you, he's coming after you. That's why the scripture talks about in Ephesians to put on the whole armor of God that you might be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. It also talks about having on the breastplate of righteousness. It talks about putting on truth, having the belt, your belt shone with the preparation of the gospel. I don't think I'm quoting that right. But it talks about the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the enemy.
All right.
We've got to learn how to fight. This is Brother Paul. His name first was Saul.
Yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
He had to learn how to fight.
Well.
At one time in the ninth chapter of Acts, he was fighting against the church, against the saints of God.
Well.
Knowing only the law. And he used that to persecute the church.
Well.
And he felt good about it.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
He even supported them when they stoned and killed Stephen. Until God in the ninth chapter knocked him down.
Yes. All right.
He went as far as to get legal rights to lock saints up because they were preaching Jesus.
Well.
But on the way, God knocked him down and made something and revealed something unto him. He said, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? The Lord said, Saul said, who art thou, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom thou persecuted.
All right.
It's hard to kick against the prick. A lot of people are fighting and kicking, and they don't know who they're fighting with.
Glory. Thank you, Jesus.
They don't realize how hard it is to try to fight the Creator, God Himself. They don't realize that they can't get to God unless they go through Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Except you believe that I am He, the scripture said, you shall die in your sin.
That's right. All right.
And the Bible also talks about how this gospel is hid to them that are lost.
Thank you, Jesus.
And what if some don't believe tonight?
Uh-huh.
The world's going about as it is, thinking everything's going to be all right.
All right.
They don't realize they're fighting a principality and a power that's higher than they are. They think they're fighting men, flesh and blood.
Well,
the saints think they're fighting flesh and blood.
Hallelujah.
And you're thinking I can win against another person.
Uh-huh.
But we're not really fighting against flesh and blood, Saul said, Paul said. But we're fighting principalities.
All right.
But I hear the same apostle saying in Colossians, God gave him power, how God gave Jesus authority and power. And exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. And that he has the power and the authority over all flesh. And he created all things for his life, in his likeness, for his goodness, for his purpose, and for his cause. Don't think man is going to be able to continue as he is.
Well,
God's got a plan.
Yes.
God's got a reason.
Yes.
God made us that we may worship him.
Yes. Well,
and him only.
All right.
No wonder God stressed who he was to the children of Israel.
Well,
and he's stressing tonight to the church. I am the Almighty God.
All right.
And beside me there is none else. Thou shalt have no other God before me.
Well,
they're telling you in Acts, they begin to tell them, don't let it spread no further. You need to stop preaching so much Jesus.
Well,
I don't want to hear you teach nor preach in this man's name.
Yes.
That's what the Sanhedrin court said.
Well,
see, the law is on their side.
Yeah.
They don't believe Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord.
I'm going to hurry up here.
Bless
but we see, after God revealed himself to Brother Saul and uh-huh. called him Paul,
uh-huh.
he had to wait on Ananias to come and lay hands on him. But after he received the revelation, after he received the knowledge of who God is,
uh-huh.
he had to wait on the church to come and lay hands on him. And then Ananias took him down in Jesus' name. And the scales fell from his eyes and he began to realize who he was dealing with.
All right.
Who he's been persecuting all this time. Be very careful who you're messing with.
All right.
You could be persecuting God.
All right now.
You call yourself knocking up against the church.
Come on.
The church is the body of Christ tonight.
All right.
Oh, and you've got to give an account of everything you say, think, and do.
Yes.
Come on. We've got to give knowledge to God.
That's right.
You've got to realize that the church is the body. We're just members in particular.
Yes. All right.
In the body of Christ tonight.
Yes.
And then Paul said, now whatsoever you do in one of his epistles, do it all in God's name.
Yes, sir.
I heard him say in Corinthians, we didn't come preaching ourselves.
All right.
But Christ Jesus. This is the time to preach Jesus, Stephen.
Hallelujah.
I don't care if they strictly command you not to.
Jesus.
It's time to preach Jesus.
Hallelujah.
It's time to talk about Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Y'all pray for me.
All right.
It's time to lift up Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
There's not many witnesses around us, y'all.
Thank
but
you,
God's Jesus. Trying to teach you how to fight.
Yes, yes.
God's trying to teach you how to put up your sword.
Thank you, Jesus.
And make the word of God your sword tonight.
Hallelujah.
God's trying to teach you how to be still and know that he's God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. There is none else.
Thank
God's
you.
Trying to teach you there's only one God to serve.
All right.
And he's a jealous God.
Yes.
Why? Because he took the time to spoke things into existence.
Yes, sir.
We didn't speak them into existence. We're just here with the creature of the Creator.
All right.
Hallelujah. Do you know who God is tonight?
Come on.
Then it's time to open your mouths
yes.
and give him the glory.
Yes.
Give him the praise
yes.
for who he is. Hallelujah. He's the Almighty God of heaven.
Hallelujah.
He's the one that's here tonight, right here among us. He's looking for praise.
Hallelujah.
He's worthy of the praise.
Yes.
Pray for me. Fight the good fight of faith.
Hallelujah. All right now. That's all right.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen. Can I ask you to turn your Bibles quickly? Amen to Luke 17.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. And 11. Along with that, Deuteronomy 8. Amen. And 14. Amen. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
Luke 17 and 14 and 11 reads, now it happened as he went to Jerusalem, and he passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. Then he entered a certain village. There met him 10 men who were lepers, and who stood afar off. They lifted up their voice and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. So when he saw them, he said to them, go show yourselves to the priests. And so it was, as they went, they were cleansed. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, returned with a loud voice, glorified God, fell down on his face at his feet, giving him thanks, and he was a Samaritan. Deuteronomy 8, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. I think it's 11. It's that 14. Beware that you do not forget the Lord your God, but not keeping his commandments, his judgments, and his statutes, which I command you this day. Speak, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Glory. Where is God's praise?
Come on.
Hallelujah. Where is his praise? Hallelujah.
Right.
There was one leper. Hallelujah. One out of 10. God healed him. He took the leprosy away. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
One came back to give God praise.
Uh-huh.
Only one saw himself and said, I got to go back.
All right.
And give God some praise.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank
God
you.
Has saved us. He has shed his blood on Calvary's mount.
Yes.
He has took us down in Jesus' name.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. He's given us the precious gift of the Holy Ghost.
He's
kept us down through the years.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Apostolic Church of Jesus has been in existence for about 27 years.
All right.
Amen. And God has had we've been up
and we've been down.
Right.
We've been almost leveled to the ground.
Yes.
But God has always kept us.
Always.
Hallelujah. In good times, in bad times.
Yes.
God has made a way out of nowhere.
Yes.
God has kept his people together.
Thank you.
God has kept a roof over our head.
Yes.
We never missed a service.
Yes.
We never missed the word of God.
Hallelujah.
No matter how low we were, God always sent a word to his people.
Yes.
God has kept the man of God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
He's given him a kidney.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He's took him off dialysis. He's put him back on dialysis.
Right.
God has kept the man of God.
Yes.
He's never missed, hallelujah, feeding
you,
his people.
Hallelujah.
When he was in the hospital,
yes,
God sent a messenger to take his place.
Right.
Because God, hallelujah, you are important to him.
Yes.
You are the sheep of his pasture.
Yes.
You are his children.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He laid down his life for you. Hallelujah. He said before
hallelujah
the foundation of the world,
glory,
he looked ahead and made a way out of no way.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
But who's gone back and giving God praise?
Glory.
Hallelujah. We have to pray sometimes.
Yeah.
We have to pray and to put your hands together.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Because God is looking for your praise.
Yes.
God wants to do something for Apostolic Church of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. But we have not thanked him for what he's already done.
Yes.
Midst of this church.
Yes.
I don't understand why this church
hallelujah
has so many old people in it.
Yes.
I don't understand how God has kept these people.
Yes,
hallelujah.
He's kept them with the mind. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. They got their aches and their pain, but they come through the door.
Hallelujah.
Every Wednesday,
yes,
every Sunday, hallelujah,
hallelujah
afternoon. Hallelujah to give God praise. God is going to do something in the midst of his church. Hallelujah. You're not here for fame and fortune, but you're here to glorify the name of the Lord. He wants to praise so he can move in Apostolic Church of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. I want to go back and give him praise for what he's already done. I remember going in the water. Hallelujah. Over 20 years ago, he took my sins away. Water, hallelujah, and went to the altar, hallelujah, on a joy night service.
Yes.
You don't know what that is, they don't have them anymore.
Amen.
But it's a Sunday afternoon service, afternoon, but it's an evening service, about 6:30, hallelujah, on Sunday evening, hallelujah. I got baptized, hallelujah, on a Sunday night, hallelujah. I got out of the water, went straight to the altar,
hallelujah.
It was full of folks that just got out of the water.
Yes.
Hallelujah, they were saying, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say thank you, Jesus.
Oh.
Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say thank you, Jesus.
Thank
I begin
Jesus
to cry out, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
with a loud voice, saying thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Hallelujah. And something begin to happen. Hallelujah. Something begin to rise up in me.
Yes.
Hallelujah. My tongue starts flickering. Hallelujah. I start speaking in another tongue that I didn't understand. Hallelujah. I heard somebody come out with the mic.
Hallelujah.
And heard myself speak out loud. Didn't know what I was saying, but I could feel it all over me. And like fire shut up in my bones. I ran up and down in that place.
Yes.
Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah.
I ran up and down.
Yes.
They turned the lights out on me.
Yes.
The deacons had their coat on. Hallelujah.
Thank
they was
you
ready to go. But I was still praising my God.
Yes.
Because I remember, hallelujah, that he brought me out of darkness.
Yes.
Into his marvelous light.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That's what we should be doing tonight.
Yes.
Running up and down in these places.
Yes.
We should let them turn from. I remember the pastor, this pastor right here, he told me not to forget this night.
Yes,
I didn't
Lord
understand it then.
Yes.
I didn't understand what
hallelujah
he was talking about.
Yes.
He said, don't forget what God has done for you
yes
this night.
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I never forgot, hallelujah,
yes,
the feeling that I had. Saints of God, saints of God,
hallelujah,
don't forget what God is doing right now.
Yes.
Don't forget what God has brought you from.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You look at yourself. You're old, but you're good.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Come on.
You might be old, but you ain't mad because I caught you. Oh, I'm trying
come
to
on,
get on. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You look good, sir. Hallelujah. Apostolic Church
Hallelujah.
Of Jesus, you look good.
Yes.
Give God some praise.
Yes.
Give him some glory.
Yes.
We're going to go back and give him some praise.
Yes.
I'm going to go back and think about his goodness and his mercy and his everlasting love for me. And I'm going to give him some praise in 2017. In 2017, I'm going to make a change. Bibles. Turn to Psalm 24. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Go look at verse 7. Starting at verse 7. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is this King of glory. Selah. Hallelujah. If I were to take a text, it would be to keep your head up. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. In this time, we've gone through the year that we have gone through, the many ups and downs, the trials and tribulations, the heartaches, the joys, the pains, the sickness, the healings, the deliverance. God has kept us.
Yes, yes.
And through this whole time, all we had to do was lift up our heads. And in 2017, he's telling us still, lift up your head. If you keep your eyes on Jesus, you'll stay afloat. See, what happened when Peter stepped out of the boat, when he took his eyes off of Jesus, he started to sink. As long as we keep our eyes on Jesus, we'll stay afloat. If we keep our eyes on Jesus, our healing is nigh. If we keep our eyes on Jesus, our deliverance is nigh. If we keep our eyes on Jesus, no matter what comes, if we keep our eyes on Jesus, he got us. No matter what comes, if we keep our eyes on Jesus, he got us. The devil can throw many toils and snares, but Jesus got us. All we got to do is keep our eyes on him. If your eye is on the prize, you have nothing to worry about. Why? Because Jesus is going to win it for us. Through Jesus, we have the victory. Jesus is the one that's going to fight, not us. We don't have to fight. All we got to do is keep our eyes on him. If we keep our eyes on Jesus, he will fight for us. If we keep our eyes on Jesus through the word, if we keep our eyes on Jesus in prayer, if we keep our eyes on Jesus in praise, if we keep our eyes on Jesus in worship, if we keep our eyes on Jesus, he will win it for us. We have the victory in Jesus. If we keep our eyes on him, we won't sink, we won't fail, we won't waver. If we keep our eyes on Jesus, we won't sink, we won't have to swim, we won't fail, we won't waver. If our eyes stay on Jesus, keep your eyes on Jesus. When the haters come, keep your eyes on Jesus. When the tests come, keep your eyes on Jesus. When the trial comes, keep your eyes on Jesus. When the heartache comes, keep your eyes on Jesus. When the pain comes, keep your eyes on Jesus. When death comes, keep your eyes on Jesus. When Trump comes, keep your eyes on Jesus. It don't matter what you're going through, keep your eyes on Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
The Lord has
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Been good to apostolic
you, Jesus.
Church of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
I know that.
Hallelujah.
They're looking at us. They're watching us.
Thank you, Jesus.
But I know that God has kept us these 27 years. One has come, and it seems like they have zoomed past where we are. Have a big congregation. The people are flocking. And I wonder sometimes those that I know that have even gathered themselves there. What did they get there that they didn't get here? Or do they remember? Did they get what they got here?
Thank you, Jesus.
Because I understand what's happening. But I'm wondering, do you thank God for what you got?
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Give God the glory.
Hallelujah.
Give God the glory.
Hallelujah.
It's time to make your choice.
Thank you, Jesus.
Deuteronomy says, choose you this day.
Yes.
Whom you shall serve.
Thank you, Jesus.
We've got to learn to put our trust in God.
Thank you, Jesus.
We got to learn how to show God thankfulness.
Yes.
Not show God that we don't need him because of what we have.
Thank you, Jesus.
But we got to show God that we don't have
Hallelujah.
What we need without him.
All right.
I need him.
Yeah.
I need the blood of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I need the power of Jesus. He's kept me. I know he's kept me. My body has been at death's door. But he lifted me again. He blessed me again. He's given me renewed strength. To hold on to him. I want the apostolic church of Jesus to know I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I'm not ashamed of who's brought me out and has kept me this 27 years. He's about to do great things, but he's already done it. He's doing great things for me right now. I look and see when I did what I thought I needed to do that we might be very solvent.
Thank you, Jesus.
Everything that I did, God put his hand in it.
Hallelujah.
And he didn't let it happen the way I wanted it to happen.
Thank you, Lord.
I said, I've done, Lord, and we should have. But we don't have. Because we did things. We got all our bills paid. We got all our bills paid.
Yes.
And I said, Lord, we should have more right now. But God did not let it accumulate. God got something else in store. God's got something else. He said, the cattle on a thousand hills is mine. Silver and gold is mine. Great God Almighty. Yes, I know how to save money. Yes, I know how to put money away. But when God puts his hand to it, he has got the hold of it. And I can't change what God does. I got to trust him. He's brought me out.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm not in debt.
Thank you, Jesus.
When I should be in debt.
All right. Hallelujah.
but I'm not in debt.
Thank you, Jesus.
Last time my credit was checked, the man said, man, you got good credit. I said, yeah. He said, yeah. It ain't many people that got credit like you.
All right.
He said, your credit rating is 854.
Lord.
I said, I didn't know that.
All right.
But I eat every day. I have fuel for the car.
All right.
I pay the car note. Thanking God.
All right.
As my wife said, we got the bill from the hospital. Hospital for about, I don't think it was a complete 5 days. It was $31,000.
Thank you, Jesus.
God knows. If I had to pay that,
oh yes, Lord,
I'd be in big trouble.
Thank you, Jesus.
I know that God has kept me. Yes. Apostolic Church of Jesus, God is on our side.
Thank you, Jesus.
I believe in the year 2017. Yes,
yes. All right.
We shall see the hand of the Lord.
Glory. Yes, Lord.
Work in apostolic.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Church of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
But I want you to know this. God's going to work, you, but you got to go to work.
That's all right. Thank you, Jesus.
You got to go to work.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
You're going to learn how to give.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
You're going to learn how to give. And the more you give, you're going to know that God has blessed you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Jesus.
You're going to see that God is the provider. You've been saying, we got nobody but old folk.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's right. I'm 76, another one 76, another one 79. Hey, old folk. But see, old or young, it's not too hard for God. God has brought us. And God's going to show you just how great he is.
Yes,
I wanted to see all our young people, as God has blessed them to go, to come.
Yes.
There's a lot of them out there.
Yes.
Sister Ashley put my birthday on Facebook, and so many wish me happy birthday. I said, wow, they ain't forgot me yet. It's time for them to be back and serve the Lord. If they all return, we have a full house.
All right now.
And it's all the young folk having a good time out in the street. It's time to prepare ourselves to move into the year 2017.
Hallelujah.
I want you to stand to your feet.
Hallelujah.
And we want to go before the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
As we welcome the year 2017 in this hour. Let us pray. Let's just give him praise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. You brought us here. You kept us here. The end of it. We want to thank you, Lord. We want to give your name the glory. Help us, Lord, to remember where you brought us from. To remember what you're doing for us right now, Lord. Pour out your spirit. Forgive us of our transgressions. Forgive us of our shortcomings. Help us to overcome, Lord. Oh, we praise you, we praise you. Lift your hands and give him praise. Lift your hands and give him praise. Lift your hands and give him praise. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Oh, bless your name tonight, Lord. Bless your name tonight, Lord. Pour out your spirit here, Lord. Oh, pour out your spirit here, Lord. We love you, Jesus. We love you. We love you. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. One Lord, one faith. One Lord. One Lord, one faith. There's one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one Lord, one baptism, one Lord, one faith. Tell it everywhere. Oh yes, it's one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one Lord, one faith. Tell it everywhere I go. worship you with it now. You got to praise. Give it to the Lord. Sister Mo.
Thank you.